Hello everyone. So now we are going to do this one, configure and verify layer 2, layer 3 ether channel LACP. They mention LACP, but we are going to do the PAGP as well as manual method. So before going to the main concept, let me explain you some more detail, then we can look for the this ether channel. Imagine, let me draw some diagram and show you here. Imagine you have two switch, okay? Let me draw here. Let me take my pen tool and imagine I have switch here, okay? I have switch one here. This is a switch one, okay? I have another switch here. This is a switch two. I have two switch. I am taking a small scenario. You can imagine you have 20 switch instead of this one, and I connected here this one, okay? And maybe this is a gigabit speed, okay? In between the link, gigabyte 1 GB speed in between the switch. But you need to have the speed, imagine 6 GB in between the switch. So how we can increase? First option, you can go and you can ask the, you can increase, you can upgrade this link. You can upgrade this link. How you will upgrade? Instead of using 1 GB, you can upgrade to 6 GB. But this will cost you. Maybe your interface will not support the 6 GB. So you need to change the interface. Maybe you need to change the switch. So it will cost you. You need to invest money on that one to change the hardware. Another method, what you will say? You will say, I have, this is 1 GB, I will put one more cable, this is 2 GB, I will put one more cable, this is 3 GB, I will put one more cable, this is 4 GB, I will put one more cable, 5 GB, and this is a 6 GB. So this is the, you put the 6 cable, one cable is supporting 1 GB, so now you have the speed of 6 GB gigabyte. But the problem, if you do practically like this, your spanning tree protocol will disable. Okay, your spanning tree protocol will disable, and only one port is working. I hope you remember, just now we cover spanning tree. What is a STP? That is a spanning tree protocol, is a protocol which is going to disable the link which is creating the loop in the network. Okay, spanning tree protocol is a layer 2 protocol which is disabling the link which is creating the loop in the network. We already know that one. But here what we are saying, we have the two hardware, we connected with the link, our interface is gigabyte and it is supporting 1 GB. We need to have the speed 6 GB. So we are thinking maybe we can change the hardware, but instead of changing the hardware, we are saying maybe we have one more solution, that is we will increase the link. Instead of connecting one link, we will connect the 6 link. So we can have the 6 GB speed. But the problem, spanning tree protocol is going to block that one. If you want, I will show you that one also. We can check in the packet tracer. I can show you that one in the packet tracer, how it is disabling. Let me go to the packet tracer and show you that one. Okay, let me show you that one. I will go in the, let me take any packet tracer here. Okay, let me move here. I will take some switch. Okay, let me take the layer 3 switch. This is a layer 3 switch. I am taking switch 1, okay, and switch 2. I have two switch. Let me make zoom in this one, and then I will take the cable. I will take cable from here to here. This is a gigabyte. If you remember, just now I am taking the example for the gigabyte. This is a gigabyte interface. So I want to increase the speed, that is 6 GB. So I will connect the 6 cable. I will connect the 6 cable. So let me disable the port interface. So easily we can observe how many cable we are connecting. So this is a 3. So what I will do, I will connect one more. This is a 4, and I will connect one more. And if you observe here, all are red. Why all are red? Because this is a multi-layer switch. Here we have the power supply we need to put. So what I will do, I will take this one, I will put here. Okay, we have dual power supply. We need to put two power supply. One power supply is from the UPS, one power supply we can give from our socket. Okay, generally we, in the real scenario, if you go in our server room or in our room, wherever we install our servers, routers, switches, in the rack, if you go in the rack, you will see that one. Physically, you will have the device. In the device, nowadays, new device, all new device have two power supply. One is working, one is standby. If anything go wrong, example, if power supply one, if imagine this power supply fail, your device will not go down. Your device will not go down, it will work on this one. Okay, so redundancy purpose we are using this one. So I put the power supply and I will go to this switch also. I will install the power supply to this switch also. I am installing here. So now we will see, this is our switch, it will start working. And let me go here inside the switch and see in the console. If you see, we have the switch here. Let me write here no, and then if you press enter, and if you see here, this is all are in the umber color. It will take some time, we need to wait some time, and it will take, if you remember, 30 to 50 seconds it will take, go from the listening, learning, then it will go in the forwarding. So it will take some time, it will take some time. Okay, so what we are waiting, or if you don't want to wait, in the packet tracer you can press this fast forward, but in the real scenario you cannot do fast forward, you need to wait. Okay, let me make little zoom. If you see here, this port is enabled, only one port. We are thinking we have the 6 cable we connected, now we will have the speed of 6 gigabytes, but the problem here, one port is working, remaining port is disabled because of spanning tree protocol. So we have these types of issue if we are connecting. So what we can do to overcome these types of issue, we will use the ether channel we are going to use. So let me show you that one, the diagram which we discussed just now. If you see here, we have these types of issue. To overcome these types of issue, we will go for the ether channel. We can say ether channel is a technology which allow us to make multiple physical interface into single logical interface. Let me write here, see here, I can say this one is a, this from here to here, from here to here, this is a physical interface. How many you have? You have six interface, that is physical. So what I will do, I will use this 6 physical interface, I will make one logical interface. I will take this 6 physical interface, then I will make it to one logical interface with the help of ether channel. So what we can say, ether channel, let me write here, ether channel is a technology. We can say, you can reproduce in your own words, we can say ether channel is a technology which allow us to make the multiple physical interface into one logical interface. So spanning tree protocol will not block us. Spanning tree protocol will not block multiple interface. Okay, and this ether channel is also known as link aggregation. Another name for the ether channel is link aggregation, or we can say port aggregation. Some guys are saying port aggregation, that is also same. Ether channel other name is link aggregation, port aggregation. Many guys are saying the bundling, link bundling, port bundling, all are same. Bundling means mixing physically multiple physical interface into one logical interface. So you need to remember, in interview sometime they are asking what is link aggregation. So no need to worry, link aggregation, port aggregation, ether channel, link bundling, port bundling, all are nothing but making multiple physical interface into one logical interface, that is a ether channel. You need to remember that one. So what are the advantage we will get by doing the ether channel? You need to remember first one, what we can say by doing the ether channel, what advantage we will have? We can increase the bandwidth. Just now we see that one, how we increase the bandwidth. We have 1 GB for one link. You have now 6 links, so it will be 6 GB bytes speed. Okay, so what we can say, first advantage is we increase the bandwidth, and we have the redundancy. Redundancy means if this link go down, what we can say, let me take some more color. We have redundancy. Example, if you are working in the production network, if one cable go down, imagine this first cable is working, all other ports are disabled because of spanning tree protocol. If this port go down, then again this port will take 30 to 50 seconds to come up. Okay, if you enable RSTP, if you enable RSTP, then it will take 10 seconds, less than 10 seconds. Okay, if you enable the RSTP, it will take less than 10 seconds. But the problem, you need to wait here, right? But if you enable the Ether channel, you need to, no need to wait. All are working same time. Even if you go first link go down, all remaining five link will work. Even if this second link also go down, remaining all four links are working. Even this one also go down, it is working. Even this one also go down, it is working. Even if you have one link also, it is working. No need to wait for this 30 second or 50 second or less than 10 second. Automatically it is working. Our network will not go down. So first advantage, it increase the bandwidth. We can say Ether channel increase bandwidth and provide redundancy by aggregating the link, individual link of the switch. Or we can say Ether channel do load balancing also. It will forward the traffic. And we can configure Ether channel in layer 2 and layer 3. Layer 2 means we can configure on switches, as well as in layer 3 means we can configure on router or in the layer 3 switch also. In many router it will not support. You need to check the router specification, Ether channel is supporting or not. But in the production network we are doing layer 3 switch. Layer 3 switch, in the layer 3 switch we are doing the Ether channel. Okay, but if you want to do example, you have router R1 here and you have router R2 here. Okay, you have two router. If you want to connect this one two way, you can connect, but all the router is not supporting. You need to check the router specification sheet, which router is supporting and which router is not supporting. Okay, you can go to the Cisco website, you can download the router which you are using, that specification sheet. You will have all the specs there. You can read that one if it is supporting. In the Cisco website, you will get the catalog there. They are going to mention the configuration also. In the production network, one time we are configuring the Ether channel, some router we have and that is not supporting. So we check that one and we change the hardware and we have another hardware, and in the Cisco website, we get the configuration also. So it is easy. Just you can Google, you will get the Cisco link. And you can download that manual and you can configure that one. But in generally in the production network, we will take the layer 3 switch. And in the layer 3 switch, we can make the Ether channel. That is, we will assign multiple interface as a one. And then we will assign the IP address to that interface. Okay. So I hope this is clear for you. Just before closing this one, let me repeat again what we are saying. First point, we are saying Ether channel. Other name is link aggregation. Okay, link aggregation. Link aggregation, or we can say link aggregation. Here I miss R. Link aggregation or port aggregation, Ether channel, port bundling, link bundling, all is nothing but Ether channel. And other thing what we are saying, what advantage? Bandwidth increase. And redundancy also increase. Okay, these are the two advantage. And you need to remember, we can maximum we can do for 8 physical interface. As I am saying here, imagine I have this here switch 1 and I have switch 2 here. I want to make the link aggregation. So maximum I can do for the 8 as per the Cisco books. But if you check the switch specification, some switch are supporting more than that one also. But as per the Cisco test book, this is supporting the 8 interface. Means you can make 8 physical interface into one logical interface. Okay, 8 physical interface into one logical interface. So we have different method to do this one. First method we have PAGP. Okay, PAGP is nothing but port aggregation protocol. And another we have the LACP, that is link aggregation protocol. Another is manual method, that is nothing but statically we are going to do that one. We are calling that is manual, let me write here, manual or static mode. Okay, so with this three way we can configure the Ether channel. This is not present in our syllabus, this is not present in our syllabus, we have only LACP. But anyhow, we are going to do this one also. We are going to do this one also. So no issue. We will do that one. Okay. So this is an introduction about the Ether channel. Ether.